Good morning, everyone. First of all, I would like to thank each one of you for subscribing to my channel, for writing such lovely comments, for showering so much love. You inspire me every single day. And I cannot express how grateful I am to each one of you. Now let's get into the video. You can see that I have a couple of cuttings over here. So recently, I repotted my Ixora plant and I took out a few cuttings from it. You can see that this one is really long. So I want to tell you that whenever you want to propagate Ixora or any other plant, what are the few things that we should keep in mind? So first of all, I'll talk about the don'ts. Don't take a cutting which is this long. Like, this is way too long. So I think that if I cut it like until here, it would be of the appropriate size, the decent size, because this, I think it might grow, it might not grow, I don't know. But they say that, you know, it's better to take like maybe a 5-inch, 6-inch cutting. So don't take cuttings that are way too long. Now, secondly, you have to remove the extra leaves or all the leaves. Just keep a few because the stem, actually, first of all, we have cut the stem. It's not able to produce the food because it's no longer a part of the tree. So the, you know, making food, doing photosynthesis is a trouble. So remove the excess leaves. So you can see that I've cut the leaves into small bits and I have kept only a few. The others I have removed it. So point number two, remove the excess leaves. Now point number three being, which is the do, that you have to keep your cutting very, very moist and very fresh. Because anyway, the food will require moisture to survive. So it's keep the potting mix moist and please be careful that it should not be very dry. So you can spray it with some water and just check the soil that it's not dry and you watered it regularly. Also, don't put it into direct sunlight. If you put it into direct sunlight, the cutting is definitely going to burn because it's very delicate. It's not, you know, it's not a complete plant. There are no roots, so it's in a very sensitive spot. So it is advisable that you keep it in a shady area so that the plant is not dying out of dehydration. Now another thing you have to check out whenever you're taking a cutting, don't take cuttings that are entirely new or entirely fresh. You look out for cutting which is slightly mature. It's not entirely brown and it's not entirely light green. The tender ones, don't take that. Take for something which is you know, slightly mature. So you can see that these are not very brown nor they are very light green. Of course, the top portion is going to be lighter or more tender in the texture and all, because this is the growing area. But try to take cuttings which are slightly mature. And lastly, take a decent size cutting, a healthy cutting, not with which has got maybe some brown spots or burning leaves. Try to take fresh cuttings, healthy cuttings, because they have a higher rate of survival. So yes, that's all for today. And these cuttings, I am going to plant them into a mixture of 50% garden soil, 50% sand, and I'm going to place them in a shady area. I'm going to water them regularly. I'm going to mist them and keep them fresh so that they do well. And also, I'm going to plant I'm going to put one or two of them into water and see if they develop roots in water as well. So I'll be doing that. So yes, that's all for today. One thing I'd like to tell you that if you want me to, if you have any garden related trouble or any query, you can write down to me in the comment section below. Please give me suggestions if you want me to make more videos or what kind of videos you'd like to see. And lastly, you can follow me on Instagram. My Instagram handle is Suhasini Lives Satvik, and I'm going to link it in the description box below. And I'm very active on Instagram. You have any query, you have any doubt, you write to me, you DM me, and I'll help you. Okay, thank you so much for watching. Bye.